Hello and welcome back to your engineer YouTube channel. We are here presenting a course on HTML and CSS. Welcome to lecture number 8. In this lecture we are going to talk about table element. So to create a table in any HTML we are going to use three tags. First is table, that will create a format of any table you want. Second, HTR, that is going to create every row of your table. And third is TD, that will create a column for you. And if in case you want some heading for your table, you can also use th. Okay, so let's for fun I am going to create a table of few characters of TV series Game of Thrones. So let's create a table for them. So here first I am going to comment this form out. To comment anything in your Visual Studio, all you have to do is control and backslash. After that I am giving a first tag as body. First tag in body as table. So after giving table, I am going to give first thing as tr, that is my first row. In my first row I want two columns, that is first name and second last name. So for that, in case I want in my table that first name and last name should be our heading, so I am going to give th for first name. First name and last name. After that I want different rows where I can put the data like in Excel sheet. So I am going to take 5 names from Game of Thrones series. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, okay. So these are not going to be heading. So these are going to be TD. For every column, we are going to use TD. So for my first column, I am going to use TD. So in TR tag, in my second row, there will be the two column. So first is, let's say, John, and second will be Snow. After that I want to include 3 more data in our table. So let's say Jimmy Lannister Cersei Lannister and let's say Arya Stark. Now save it and run it in live server. Once we run it, I can see that there is a table created with first name and last name. Now you can see that in like an Excel there is no border here. So to create a border in your table element, all you have to give an attribute in your table tag. So I am giving here an attribute called border and I am going to give it 1, that is 1 pixel. So you can see that there is a border for each and every input in table elements. So that's how we create table in HTML. In next video, we are going to know how to reduce and increase the size of your rows and column by using row span and col span. So stay tuned with us. Thank you very much for watching this video. Like it, comment on it, and subscribe the channel. Thank you.